Julius Malema uthi, Julius Malema says he did not know that, he did not understand that VPS was doing VPS donations to be bribed. So in other words, he's like, no, mina, I didn't know ukuthi VPS donations can be translated into a bribe. No, I did not know that. But now I know that you guys are telling me that those were bribes. Because mina, all I know is that we were just receiving donations, not bribes. Two different things. Oh, my daughter. Oza Malema. Oza Malema. As quoted by Innocentia Nkadimeng, where Times Life released the article released on the 26th of July 2024 at about 17 past 2 p.m. In this article, Malema was heard saying the following: "Hi guys, ningangifaki mina kule ntama phela abantu baya donate la ku UFF. So if people baya donate la, manje mina ngizowazi kanjani ukuthi le donation le yi bribe? Ngoba ngicabanga ukuthi wonke ama donation i donation. Manje nasenyangitshela ukuthi bekungama bekuy look this was a bribe. Ay mina ngizwa ngani? Besingazi thina ukuthi bribe. Thina besazi ukuthi donation. Da de di do to donation." I don't know what I'm doing there. Donation. That's what Malema is saying. Donation. You know what I'm saying? That is what Malema is saying. You know, my God. Hey, I'm Malema. Malema is going to tell this good team. He studies you, right? He sees that you are hostile against him. Hey, this guy's going to deal with you. When I look at people there, Malema, before he does an interview, rest assured, he knows about you. They do their investigation about the journalist, and they will know, good, okay, I'm going to be interviewed by this journalist. This journalist hates me. They will go for you. They make it difficult for you to go against them because they will go against you. Hey, Malema, my goat, in terms of handling haters who are interviewing you. That guy, he studies everybody. Journalist. But, okay, Ashley Lap, well, we were not there to begin with. EFF Julius Silo Malema says he was not aware that the donation then VPS Mutual Bank Chairperson Chipewa Matanzi offered to the party was a bribe. I mean, guys, I'm aware. That you guys are not doing this.
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the super thanks button in case you don't want to do that. Guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, let's continue here. Matodzi claimed in an affidavit that the EFF was paid 5 million lump sum and 1 million monthly donations in 2017 to clean up the bank's bad reputation after giving then President Jacob Zuma a loan for his nkondla. If the affidavit says monthly donations, then where did we get the interpretation that it was bribery? It could be that we got it from DA. I did not say much, but it could be that the interpretation, we got it from DA. Because I think I need to go back to Matodzi's statement and listen to the statement itself. What is Matodzi saying in those statements? But specifically, is it phrased as a donation or as a bribe? But I read the statement. I don't remember hearing the word bribe. I do remember hearing the word donation. I do remember vividly that. Malema argued that when Matodzi offered the Red Beret the donations, he did not understand it to be a bribe. Let me say this way as well. I will tell you this. Né? Somebody just donated 1,000 rand not long ago. But if you're looking, I don't even know the person. One person will come and say that was a bribe. Maybe coming from that, it makes a lot of sense. I don't know. You'll tell me. You'll tell me that. Malema says, the guy Matodzi said in his own sponsored affidavit that he offered to donate to the EFF. He didn't say the EFF came to ask him for money. So since when is a person donating to EFF a crime? Then he said in the same paragraph, they knew when they donated the 5 million, it was a gratification. Nami, I was like, who said Velod was a bribe? Because maybe we are interpreting this using a borrowed narrative or a borrowed mindset. Why we are so keen to talk about the criminals? Yeah, the EFF, the criminals. But yeah, he's staying off 30 million to DA to 50 million. Nobody says anything about it. It's not even a conversation. It's not even trending for some strange reasons. EFF eating the granny's money. Yay. 30 to 50 million from Steinhoff. A house bought for a car, in fact, bought for Muslim man. Nobody's saying anything about it. I told you. Who's writing? How many journalists, how many publications are writing about Palapala, calling Ramaphosa Palapala? Nobody. I only saw IOL that they are talking about this. But the others, no. Hey, guys, it appears like we are purposefully being misled here. We are not saying the EFF, they have not committed things here. We are saying how people are treated should be equal. Nobody's talking about Palapala here. I'm very upset that people are not talking about Palapala. Utumalema, through his own sponsor, he Matodzi doesn't claim to have met me before. He said the same day they met me, he was going to make a donation. I understand that. How do I understand to mean a bribe? Oh my God. Malema Gelon. Some people say VPS Mutual Bank to me. But they are sitting next to a mayor who deposited money into VPS Mutual Bank. They say they can't work with EFF because it's corrupt, but they work with ANC, which has ministers who is charged as a speaker, who is charged mayors and provincial leaders who deposited into the VPS Mutual Bank. Nobody's saying anything about it. I'm like, ah, my God, I'm a landy. Former Limpopo Premier Stan Matabataba was the ANC chairperson when the VPS Mutual Bank looting was taking place. What happened now? He got a promotion. He's a deputy minister of land reform and rural development. Yet people say they can't work with those who were uloko, who worked with VPS. That is DA. DA says, no, we're not going to work with VPS looters, people who are stealing the granny's money. I futhi ngangitshela ngalabo amaxoko okugcina ke lawo. Lawo hypocrites of note, DA. I've never seen people who are such hypocrites, like who are such hypocrites like DA. I've never seen abantu abangamaxoko njenge DA. Uthi Malema maqhubeka. Myself, Julius Malema, and Floyd Shivambo understood that the concept of donations means gratifications. Hence, Floyd and Julius did not provide me with the EFF's own banking details to these donations. My daughter's statement reads, so I said EFF. Speaking about that, there's something very interesting about this whole thing. I've been telling you that you must be fearful of media. They've got the tendency of selling propaganda. They are very good in selling propaganda. Mainstream media and propaganda. Same WhatsApp group. Ask those 2 to 3 questions. What happened to the ministers that looted EVPS, who are members of the ANC? Nothing happens to them. Why is nothing happening to them? I don't know. Don't ask me. I don't know. But I know that something is definitely happening for others. Okay. Go into this one. Ask me what happened to the other people who are directly involved with the VPS. Why are their name not shine? No, why are we not putting a spotlight on their names? I don't know. Just tell me that. I don't know. Why are we looking at EFF and not concerned about Ramaphosa and Palapala as well? Because if it's the matter of justice, then it's not justice because we have gotten the EFF charged or arrested, but it's also justice because we have also gotten Palapala charged and arrested. We have also gotten the DA charged and arrested for the money they received from Steynhoff. It can't be a criminal offense if it doesn't involve the DA, but it's not a criminal offense when it involves the DA. I mean, it's business when it involves the DA. No. Same thing must apply to everybody. What we do on the right, we must do. What we do on the left, we must do on the right. It's just, you know what I'm saying? As simple as that. Tell me in the comment section below. It was good for these people to lose their money, go VPS. Certainly no. I'm not saying that. Nah. Am I saying people who are guilty of doing that crime should not perish? Certainly they should perish. But I like what the organization that is in charge or that is pushing this thing, Oguti, people who are behind this thing, they should be arrested. I like that because how they approached it, they are like, Tina, we are not saying EFF, we are not saying ANC people or what. We are saying every person who is implicated in this thing must be arrested equally. That's what I like about them. I was listening to what they were saying. I was like, wow, they sound proper. Not this thing of us being told we must hate this one, love this one, because hey, nanaskato cholo amuntu mele ngithanda ubani ngingathanda ubani hayi ikoloti mina phela mina ngiphakelwa ke mina hayi mina ngingancane hayi ngidlikini mina ngiphakelwa ke mina ngazange ngitshele mele ngizonde ubani ngazange ngathanda ubani hayi mele ngimzonde hayi mele ngamzonge hayi mele ngamthande sengitshela uwe manje mele ngithanda ubani ngingathanda ubani hayi na unkulunkulu osemhlabeni mina nenkulunkulu osezulwini phela. Pelela lapho futhi idlula lapho. Tell me what you think in the comment section below. What do you think? Get into the conversation below. Tell me what you think about everything. You and I will see on the next video. But until such a time, please take care.